Here's a good example of, in my opinion, about old paradigm and new paradigm of principles. And for example, here we can see, if we go to the first one, we can see a situation where we have four orange defenders, three midfielders, and three strikers. So this is a kind of 4-3-3 system. But then on the second draw, you can see a 3-4-3, and in the third draw, you can see a 4-4-2. And if you really see this, for example, 4-4-2, you can say, yes, this is a 4-4-2. But actually, the situation is that all the circles are all the time in the same position. I mean, nothing is really changing. It's just the way you, as coach, you interpretate the reality. If you interpret the reality in a way of 4-3-3, you always see 4-3-3. If you do it 3-4-3, you see 3-4-3. So that gives, for me, the insight that the systems are not really useful, no longer useful, in my opinion, because systems are based on precisely the old paradigm of coaching, where players have a specific role and they have to do this because you are playing left defender and left defender. So if we go, I think if we go towards the future, in the future we will have principles and we have like multifunctional players that they can play at the back and they can go in the center or play on the width, blah blah blah. So, but more dynamic situation. So just, if you are one of these coaches that really thinks a lot about systems and five different systems and positioning and really love to put things on your board and move, okay, then my recommendation, if I can, is that you leave your board a little bit aside and try to work more on principles. Here, there are like three new ways of understanding also the system, which are different, like the ones, the traditional line by line. So for example, in the first one, we can have a situation where we have outsiders and insiders. And outsider is a situation where you are playing in front of the, like facing the central part of the game, of the field, sorry. If you are inside, you have to develop the 360 awareness. So, like, you can divide your players also in these two roles if you want. So it's a new way of understanding the roles of the players, but it's also possible. And you can also let them exchange outside, inside. If you are inside, these are the important principles. If you are outside, these are the other important principles, and you can structure your process based on that. In the second one, you can say what we want is to understand the players depending, the role of the player depending on the distance to the ball carrier or where is the ball. So you can have close players, you can have ball carrier, you can have close players, and you can have distant. And you can have principles for distant players, you can have principles for close players, and you can have principles for ball carrier, let's say. It's another way. And in the last one, you can have players at the back and you can have players up front, and you can say, oh, these two guys will always be here and they will be in charge of the outlet, and two really strikers, and but all the others are like dynamic, let's say, midfielders that they can join both. But I mean, you can decide everything, but my point is that we have to start thinking about system and the way the system works based on principles, not the former based individual position and roles.